Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Love Starter. In this video, we'll look at how we can get started using Google Optimize. This is my updated Google Optimize tutorial. Now, what we'll do is we'll begin by looking at how we can get started by creating our account, and then importantly, we'll look at how we can add Google Optimize to our website. Specifically, we'll look at using Google Tag Manager to do this. Then we'll look at how we can actually create our very first experiment. We'll begin with an A/B test inside Google Optimize, and I'll also talk about the different features and other ways that you can actually use Google Optimize on your website. Okay, it's time to get started. Google Optimize lets you run experiments on your website to increase conversions and engagement. And you can use Google Optimize to personalize the content people see as they browse your website. If you're just getting started with Google Optimize, or it's been a while since you've used Google Optimize, then you're in the right place. I'm going to run through the steps to get started, including important changes to how you install Google Optimize on your website and the ways you can use Google Optimize. The first thing you'll need to do if you're getting started is to create your Google Optimize account. To do this, you just need to head to Google Optimize. I've included a link in the description below this video. You'll need to log in using your Google account and then click Get Started. If you've already created an account, then when you log in, you'll see the account you've already created. I need to decide if I want to share data from my Google Optimize account with Google. Then I need to select my location and accept the terms and conditions. Before we create our first experience in Google Optimize, let's link our account to Google Analytics and add the Google Optimize code to our website. To do this, let's click Settings. It's important to link Google Optimize to Google Analytics. This lets you view the performance of your experiments and personalized experiences in your Google Analytics reports. This can be really helpful. For example, you can view additional reports and even create custom segments to perform more in-depth analysis in Google Analytics. So let's click Link to Analytics. You'll then be able to link to any Google Analytics properties that you have access to using the email address you've used to create your Google Optimize account. If you don't see the Google Analytics property you want to link to, then you can check which login you've used for Google Optimize. Add this login to Google Analytics, then come back and link your accounts. You can choose which reporting views will receive data from Google Optimize. And when you're happy, it's time to click Link. The next step is to install the Google Optimize snippet on all the pages of our website. If you're going to add the Optimize code directly to your website, for example, using the code injection option in Squarespace or in your template, then we can copy the recommended snippet. This code needs to be placed on all the pages on your website, just inside the opening head tag. Let's look at how we can do this on a Squarespace website. Let's copy the snippet and head to Squarespace. We need to select Settings, then Advanced, and Code Injection. Now, all we need to do is paste the snippet into the header section and save our changes. That's it. Okay, let's head back to Google Optimize. If you've previously installed Google Optimize on your website, then it's worth checking if you're using this version of the Optimize snippet. This has recently been updated by Google, so if you're not using this version, it's worth removing the old snippet and replacing it with the latest version. Apart from adding the Optimize code directly on your website, the other option is to add the snippet using Google Tag Manager. If you're already using Google Tag Manager to add Google Analytics to your website, then this is a good option to use. we need to copy the Google Optimize container ID. And then we need to head to Google Tag Manager. Now we need to create a new tag. Name the tag. And select Google Optimize as the tag type. We need to paste our container ID from Google Optimize. And select the Google Analytics settings variable that we've already used to track the pages on our website. This also needs to be the same Google Analytics property that we linked to our Google Optimize container. We're going to save our new tag without adding any triggers. Now we're going to open our Google Analytics tag. Let's click the tag to adjust the configuration. Now we click Advanced Settings. Under Tag Firing Options, we're going to ensure that Once Per Page is selected. And now we're going to choose Tag Sequencing. And we're going to enable the option to fire a tag before our Google Analytics tag fires. And we're going to select our Google Optimize tag. That's it. Now we can save our tag. And click Submit to publish the changes to our website. If you're going to add Google Optimize to your website using Google Tag Manager, then I also recommend adding the anti-flicker snippet above your Google Tag Manager container on all the pages of your website. This helps to provide a cleaner experience as people are presented with different versions of your website. For more details about the anti-flicker snippet, I've included a link in the extra resources below this video. I'm going to show you an example so you can see how to add the anti-flicker snippet. Okay, so on this example page, we can see the Google Tag Manager container code. Now all we need to do is paste the anti-flicker snippet that Google provides. Again, you can find this in the description below the video. Now we just need to replace container ID with the ID from our Google Tag Manager container code. That's it. Now let's head back to Google Optimize. The final thing we need to do before we create our first experiment is to install the Google Optimize extension for Chrome. This extension is needed to use the visual editor and make changes to our website. So let's click Install Extension. And let's add the extension to Chrome. Okay, now we can create our first experiment. I'm going to click Let's Go. We can create an A/B test, multivariant test, redirect test, personalize the content on our website, and add a notification banner to the top of our website. Today, I'm going to create an A/B test. A/B tests are perfect when you're getting started. They work on websites and pages that receive lots of traffic and websites that only receive a small amount of traffic. They're great for testing very different ideas and even work if you have a lower conversion rate. So I'm going to name my experience Main Menu. And I'm going to enter the page that I want to improve. And I'm going to click Create. Now we need to click Add Variant. This will be the new version of the page that we test against the original version. I'm going to name the variant Join the Free Course. We can see that there are no changes to our new variant yet, so let's click Edit. Our page now loads along with the visual editor. For this experiment, I'm going to test the way my free course is included in my main menu. So I'm going to select the element I want to change. And I'm going to click Edit Element and select Edit Text. Now I'm going to change the text so that it says Join the Free Course instead of Free Analytics Course. Now I'm going to click Done. And I'm going to click Save. And just to highlight, you can change more than one element on your page. You can change the headings, text, images, and other content too. But for this experiment, I'm going to keep things simple. I recommend taking the time to preview your changes using the different device options at the top of the editor. It's important to make sure that your changes are made consistently across devices. When we're happy, we can click Done. Now that I've made the change I want to test to my website, it's time to check the other configuration options in Google Optimize. Since I want to test my new menu text across my whole website, I'm going to adjust the page targeting. If I don't, then the change we made would only be shown to people on the individual page we entered when we created the experiment. So I'm going to click Edit under Page Targeting. And I'm going to change Matches to Contains. This means the experiment will run across all the pages of my website. If you're only testing a change on an individual page, for example, if you're testing a new headline on a page, then don't change the targeting for your experiment. Now I'm going to scroll down and select the objectives for my experiment. This is where we select the metrics we want to improve. So let's select Add Experiment Objective. We can then select Choose from List, which will include any goals we have configured in Google Analytics and some other engagement metrics. And there's also the option to create a custom objective. Today, I'm going to select Choose from List. And I'm going to select the metrics I'm hoping to improve. There are some other options you can configure, but I'm happy with my experiment. So I'm going to scroll back to the top, and I'm going to click Start to launch my experiment. That's it. Now I just need to wait until enough people participate in my experiment, and then I can check back to see the results in Google Optimize. Let's close our experience. And let's select Create Experience again. Apart from A/B tests, you can also create multivariate tests in Google Optimize. Multivariate tests are ideal for pages that receive lots of traffic, if you want to test multiple elements in a page, and for refining your ideas. For example, after running a successful A/B test, then you might want to consider running a multivariate test to make smaller tweaks and refinements to your page. Multivariate tests take long to complete because each change you make creates a new variant. For example, if you tested 2 new variants for a button and 3 variants for some content, that would mean that we'd have a total of 9 variations that will be tested. We can also create redirect tests. Redirect tests let you test one page on your website against another page. For example, if you already have 2 separate pages on your website, then you can split traffic between the 2 pages to see which one provides the best results. Then there is personalization. This lets you customize the content presented on your website based on different user traits. For example, you can change text and images for people located in a particular country. If you're interested in personalizing your content, then check out my video on personalization. You can find a link in the description below. Finally, you can also add a banner to your website. Most website platforms let you add a banner, but if you can't, then this is a quick way to add a message to the top of your pages. That's it. So that's how you can get started with Google Optimize. Once you've added Google Optimize to your website, it's really easy to get up and running with either a redirect test or an A/B test to actually modify the content that people see to try and increase your conversions and conversion rate. But don't forget, there are other types of experiences you can launch on your website, right through to personalization using Google Optimize. How are you going to use Google Optimize on your website? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please subscribe, share it with your friends, and hit the like button so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.